Every March, Punahou students in the 7th and 8th grades compete in the Damon Speech Contest, a public speaking competition that has taken place since 1872. Here are this year's winners.
I remember when I was a little girl, I'd go into my mother's closet and pick out the most glamorous dress I could find. I'd put that sparkly dress over my pink and purple polka dot pajamas and slip on a pair of her most expensive shoes. I'd walk around the house trying not to trip and pretend I was a famous supermodel walking down the runway. Children who can't even walk yet are already doing this, but not with their mother's dresses, but with their very own custom-made outfits. Young girls all over the world are putting on makeup and hairspray to compete in beauty pageants to see which girl's the prettiest. I don't want our next generation to depend on looks to succeed through life, so beauty pageants for children should be banned. Beauty pageants send the wrong message to kids by making them feel like they have to be perfect. They pressure young children to have absolutely no flaws in their appearance, which is portraying that looks are everything. And isn't that exactly what we don't want our society to become? These girls are actually taught to be perfect. They are brought up in an environment that makes them believe that their outer appearance is more important than what's on the inside. Why should we have young girls become self-conscious just because of what a judge says? Everyone has their own opinion on looks, and when a girl at such a young age hears that she's not as pretty as someone else, that can easily affect her in her later years. Being in beauty pageants involves many things that a young girl shouldn't be wearing nor doing. They wear inappropriate outfits which show a lot of skin. And when a young pretty girl is walking around stage half naked, there's bound to be a strange person in the audience watching. These girls are parading around stage in outfits that full-grown, modest women would never be caught wearing, let alone a toddler. They also wear fake facial features. In order to be in a high-glitz pageant, you must wear fake teeth, have a spray tan, wear contacts, have a wig, and even have your own custom-made outfit. Can you imagine what our society would look like if everybody were to be walking around with fake teeth and a spray tan? There'll be no such thing as unique personality to express us as individuals. Every parent wants their child to be called beautiful, and that can cause some competitiveness amongst the adults. Moms will do anything to have their daughter win, and that can easily run off into the children. Pageants bring out the worst in parents. It causes them to be very uptight and demanding. And when a young girl is pressured to be perfect, stress is developed, and that can easily lead to high anxiety or depression. Why should we have young children develop high anxiety and depression just to make their parents happy? The children of today hold our future in their hands, and being conceited and depending on looks to succeed through life plays a role in how these young girls act when they become adults. Beauty pageants perpetuate the idea that self-worth is based upon your outer appearance, opposed to inner beauty. Let us all be aware that by supporting beauty pageants, we only send the message to the children of today that we are judged by how we look and not who we are. Thank you.
A philosophical speaker by name of C. Joy Belsee said that we are all equal in the fact that we are all different. We are all the same in the fact that we will never be the same. When my younger brother, who is on the autism spectrum, was applying to Punahou, he wasn't accepted because he kept to himself and didn't interact well with others. By standards such as this, kids like Albert Einstein would not have been accepted into Punahou had they been applying. My brother, who has an above average IQ, functions fine in a classroom setting now because of special helpers and programs that his school has allowed him to have. I think that Punahou School should have a special needs program for special needs kids with an average or above average IQ, because some of the greatest minds come out of children with some form of a learning difference. These kids can be too high functioning for special needs schools, where they can be forced to learn at a pace that is too slow for them. Their social interaction can also be limited, leading to a worsening rather than improvement in some symptoms. In public schools, however, the situation is even more disturbing. Research published in the Archives of Pediatrics and Adolescent Medicine states that special needs kids, typically those who have difficulty communicating and forming relationships, are far more likely to be bullied than their non-special needs peers. They also found that this risk was greatest for high-functioning kids who were too high-functioning for special needs schools and who ended up in regular school classes. This can lead to low self-esteem, plummeting grades, and in some cases, even suicide. Some special needs students are even forced to drop out of school because of the intensity of the bullying that they are subjected to. This year, 99% of Punahou seniors will be graduating, while every year, only about 40% of special needs students are able to graduate. Only about 33% go to college, and over 55% are unable to get jobs because they lack the necessary social skills and credentials in order to do so. This is why I believe that Punahou's offering of a program to these kids could be more than beneficial to both parties. With all of the resources Punahou has to offer, kids can be able to improve their social skills, to make friends in a place where they wouldn't have to worry about being bullied or being harassed for being nothing more than who they are, to explore passions like music and art and sports, and to get the same level of education, the same natural born right as the rest of us. Do I know where my 9-year-old brother is going to be in 20 years? No. Do I know where he's going to be in 10 years? No, but I can tell you where he's not going to be. He's not going to be living alone and depressed because he is going to have people behind him who are going to support him every step of the way. And he is not going to be on the streets and unemployed because he is going to get a decent education. But how many kids does this have to happen to before we decide to take action and do something about it? Thank you.